Hello students. Welcome to our YouTube channel, Chemistry Concepts by Samin Mumtaz. In this video, we will interpret and explain heating and cooling curves in terms of kinetic particle theory of solids, liquids, and gases, offering you a front row seat to the mesmerizing dance of particles that make up our physical universe. In initial step we will discuss about how do heating and cooling curves relate to the principles of thermodynamics and the kinetic particle theory. Then in final step we explain the underlying scientific concepts that are illustrated by these curves. Interpreting heating and cooling curves. As we know that a typical heating curve consists of two main sections, heating and phase changes. Similarly, a cooling curve consists of the same phases but in reverse order. Observe the graph of heating curve. It shows a steady increase in temperature as heat energy is added to the substance. The temperature increases linearly with added heat energy. At a specific temperature represents the melting phase change. During this phase, the temperature remains constant as the substance changes from a solid to a liquid. The heat energy added is used to break intermolecular forces. Then, at a specific temperature represents the boiling phase change. During this phase, the temperature remains constant as the substance changes from a liquid to a gas. The heat energy added is used to break intermolecular forces. Observe the graph of cooling curve. It shows a steady decrease in temperature as heat energy is removed to the substance. The temperature decreases linearly with removed heat energy. Therefore, we can say that the cooling curve is essentially the reverse of the heating curve. It begins with the cooling of the gas phase and then proceeds through the condensation, heating of the liquid, freezing, and cooling of the solid phases. Heating curves show how the temperature changes as a substance is heated up. Whereas, cooling curves are the opposite. They show how the temperature changes as a substance is cooled down. Now, heating section. In this part of the curve, energy is added to the substance, typically in the form of heat. As energy is added, the temperature of the substance increases steadily. The kinetic energy of the particles in the substance also increases, causing them to move more vigorously. When the substance is heated, the particles gain kinetic energy and move more rapidly. As a result, they vibrate or move more vigorously within their respective states, solid, liquid, or gas. The increase in kinetic energy is directly proportional to the increase in temperature. In this section, the substance's temperature rises steadily because the added energy is primarily being converted into kinetic energy. We already discussed these phase changes in our previous lecture, now recall again. Actually, phase changes. It is at specific points on the curve, the temperature remains constant. These plateaus represent phase transitions. The main phase transitions you'll encounter are 1. Melting and 2. Boiling. Melting, the temperature remains constant as the solid turns into a liquid. Energy is used to overcome the intermolecular forces that hold the particles in a fixed position. This energy goes into breaking these forces instead of raising the temperature. Boiling, similar to melting, the temperature remains constant as the liquid turns into a gas. Energy is used to break the intermolecular forces in the liquid to convert it into a gas. We can explain as we know that during the plateaus in the heating curve, melting and boiling, the temperature remains constant because the added energy is used to weaken or break the intermolecular forces between the particles. This energy is absorbed but not utilized to increase the temperature of the substance. Instead, it's used to convert the substance from one phase to another. Finally, it can conclude as this energy is absorbed but not utilized to increase the temperature of the substance. Instead, it's used to convert the substance from one phase to another. Cooling section. In this part of the curve, energy is being removed from the substance, typically by cooling it down. The temperature decreases, and the kinetic energy of the particles decreases. The cooling section mirrors the heating section but in reverse order. In the cooling section, the removal of heat energy results in a decrease in temperature. The particles lose kinetic energy and slow down. If the cooling is sufficient, the substance may undergo phase transitions, condensation and freezing, at the same temperature points where heating curves showed plateaus. Energy is released during these phase transitions, but it doesn't cause an increase in temperature. You can grasp the concept that energy is used to change the state of a substance or increase the kinetic energy of its particles, and this understanding is crucial in various aspects of chemistry and thermodynamics. Thanks for watching. Next topic. Describe and explain, in terms of kinetic particle theory, the effects of temperature and pressure on the volume of a gas.